A massive fight coming up between your new boy Liam Williams, and he's going to be going in there against Mark Heffron. Now, this fight was agreed in very short time. Can you talk us through the process of when you received the offer to the acceptance?
Not really. I'm not his manager. I mean, MTK managed Liam, so they sorted it all out. Liam was in the gym, obviously training for this date anyway. And at the level he's at and where he's been and where, you know, his age, you know, you can't afford to turn fights down. Whatever's laid on the table, you take the fight, and that's the kind of fighter that, you know, that Liam is. So regardless of what the terms and whatever, it doesn't really matter. What matters is that he's took this fight, and what a cracking fight it's going to be.
Absolutely. Obviously, you're very attuned to the nutrition side of the game as well. With Liam, he's always been a little bit tight at 154, as he said. He's coming up to 160. But Mark Heffron's been a big puncher at 168. Do you think that might be a feature in the fight?
Listen, if you know something about somebody and he's a big puncher, then you're not going to walk in there trying to have a punch out, are you? You know, you've got to have more to your game than being a big puncher. And this is all I keep hearing. Mark Heffron's a big puncher. Well, there's lots of big punchers out there. You know, so what? You know, boxing's more about being a big puncher. Liam's, you know, got more to his repertoire than Mark Heffron has. And, you know, he's been in our gym now for a good couple of months. Before that, previously, he was coming up to sport Kell Brook. He was a big puncher. Jason Quigley, Billy Joe Saunders. He's had some quality sparring, you know, months before this fight. And you can see something in fighters like Liam Williams, you know, what they've got, what they're made up of. And when somebody drops a big bomb on him, he doesn't crumble, he doesn't fall, he doesn't even show it. So I'm not concerned whatsoever about this tag that Mark Heffron's got, that he's a big puncher, do you understand? You know, I'd be more concerned if he was a slick boxer, because Liam Williams would have more problems, and he's not a slick boxer. So listen, we'll see on the night, you know, who's got it. You know, Liam's operated at a higher level. Mark's a new kid on the block coming through. He seems to be around a while and never really made the step up. You know, he's always like he's going to make a step up, but he never has. So this will be the acid test for Mark and maybe for Liam. You know, Liam's had two losses at world level, and we'll see.
Obviously, your gym is renowned, and your family style is renowned, turning out some amazingly slick boxers, and as well as bangers, but some amazingly slick boxers. When Liam came to you, he was known more as a boxer puncher. Have you sort of been working on the technical aspects of boxing, bringing some of that Ingle style?
You know, nothing. You know, people years ago were under the impression that, you know, that because we'd had success with Nazi and Mahmoud, that every time somebody came to our gym, we wanted to be that type of fighter. What we do with fighters is we see what they've got and try and bring out the best of them. And, you know, it's no different with Liam Williams. He's a boxer puncher, and that's what he's going to be. But he's going to be a better version of himself. His diet's a lot better, making weights a lot better. His fitness is, I'm not going to say be better, because he's always been a fit kid, but I think sometimes he's overdone it. He's been his own worst enemy. And I think, a lot of his performances, he's left it in the changing room. You know, I know his old training routine, where he'd love to spar, open spar two or three times a week, 10 and 12 rounds. It's too much. He's been cut back. He's not doing more than four or five rounds. He's doing some good fitness stuff, good runs, good pad work. His timing's great. His training's changed. So he's having to think a little bit more about what he's doing. So, you know, we're just trying to bring out the best of Liam Williams. I'm not going to change him, because why would we? He's very good anyway. He's very heavy-handed. You know, he's had some great sparring over the past months with Kell Brook, Billy Joe Saunders, Jason Quigley. You know, so he's very adaptable. He can change, you know, to fight and spar anybody.
Fair enough. And just one final question. Obviously, Liam's been characterised by taking tough fights, sometimes at very, very short notice. Again, this is another type of fight like that. Is this the sort of fight as you like working with? People are willing to jump in there and test themselves?
Look, it's not short notice, because he was training for the date. And, you know, when you're at his level, this is what you realise. Fighters, all they want to do is fight. It's not a concern. It was never an issue whether he was fighting, you know, Mark Heffron or somebody else. The point is, he's training for a date, and, you know, he's had notice, and he's making that date. It doesn't matter who's put in front of you. You know, the proper fighters take the fights that are put in front of him. Look at Kell Brook against Golovkin. You know, he was looking for a career-defining fight, and he couldn't get it at welterweight. He couldn't get it at light middleweight. So what did he do? He faced the monster of division in Golovkin, and for five rounds, he did really, really well.
And spent straight afterwards.
And spent straight after that. And that's, you've got to put yourself in the mix. He came back with a win, you know, after those two losses, and then he's boxing again in a couple of weeks' time. That's the type of fighter you want. Liam Williams is that type of fighter. I've seen Liam Williams sparring Kell Brook. Kell Brook is a much bigger, heavier puncher than Mark Heffron. Do you understand? And Liam Williams got through the rounds and did good. So I've not got no concern about, you know, this big puncher, because Mark Heffernan isn't a bigger puncher than, you know, than Kell Brook. He isn't. No matter whether he's a welterweight or whatever he is, Kell Brook is a big puncher. So we'll see.
Dominic Ingle, I really appreciate your time. Thanks very much
for speaking
to us. Cheers.
All right.